Are you researching what are the best features for a home improvement for resale? Or are you wondering what buyers are looking for when they look to buy a house? Or maybe what buyers think make an awesome house? Well, stay tuned as we go over some research statistics that cover these topics. Hi, I'm Teresa Wellman with homeownerexperience.com, your local San Jose, California realtor. And if you've watched any of my videos, you know that I love data and I like to look into statistics. So today we're going to take a little bit different spin and not talk about market statistics, but instead on statistics of what home buyers are looking for in a home. If you're considering selling your house, you might be wondering, what improvements can I make to get the best return on my investment? Or what improvements can I make to make my house really attractive to buyers? So we're gonna dig into that today. So first, I'm gonna reference some research from the National Association of Realtors about who home buyers are. Most home buyers are between the age of 22 and 64, but ages 22 to 39 are most likely to have children and are most keen on schools and other family-friendly features. So first thing to do if you're considering selling your home is to understand what is a potential buyer or who is the potential buyer for your home and what might really be attractive to them. So what do home buyers look for in a house? The National Association of Realtors has published data that talks about what home buyers are really looking for or trying to avoid. So the number one thing that home buyers agreed on that they're trying to avoid is a lot of home renovations. So sellers, that means you really need to consider doing that spruce up and renovations ahead of time to make your house most attractive to buyers. So the second thing that really stuck out in that research was that home buyers don't want to deal with electrical or plumbing problems. So make sure those areas are up to date and fully functional. Now think the HGTV effect. A lot of home buyers today have been in front of television and are used to these instant makeovers for properties. Now, we all know it's not really instant when that happens, but home buyers are really excited about properties that are move-in ready and fashionable and up to today's standard. So as a seller, it really makes sense for you to do some of those items to make your house attractive to these buyers. The first area that I really help home sellers focus on is cleaning, decluttering, and purging. So if you're currently living in the property, you'll really need to purge down, pack up, do most of your packing now, get rid of furniture that you don't want anymore or you don't plan to move. That really is gonna help open up the space for home buyers to see the house and not your furniture. The second area is to really improve your paint, flooring, and landscaping. Those three items are really key in that first impression to home buyers. If you want more specifics on this topic, watch my 8 steps to getting your house ready to sale. I will link the card up above and put the link below. Now let's get into the nitty-gritty of the actual rooms and areas that home buyers are looking for. So this study here that I will bring up on the screen is from Trulia. Trulia is a major real estate website. And the research that they did recently is interesting because it shows men's preferences and women's preferences, but you'll notice that they're actually all in the same order. So top of the list of what's important for women and men, as you can see here, is the master bath. I think if people are investing in their property, they really want to have a relaxing master bath where they can feel good in the morning getting ready or relax in the evening. The second key area is a walk-in closet. Now in San Jose with our older homes, most of them, that's not necessarily a feature that you find very often, but if you do have an ability to change up an area or maximize the closet space with really fancy organizers, that also is really key to help maximize that closet and master bedroom feel. The third item is a gourmet kitchen. Now kitchens are the heart of the home and really key for them to stand out and look great. So when I talked about paint in a home, this is an area where you could really use paint to your advantage. For example, in the kitchen, I see a lot of dated cabinetry. One of the quickest and easiest ways to update the cabinetry is to get a professional painter in to do an amazing paint job to lift that value modern style up in your kitchen. Next area that they're really interested in is an outdoor deck or patio space. I have some great examples of that. I just sold a property that buyers went crazy for. We had 9 offers and really, it was that backyard space was really special. The homeowners had spent a lot of energy and effort to make a comfortable backyard, And that really showed off well in photos and in visiting the property that it made home buyers excited. The next area is hardwood floors. Now, hardwood is always great, especially depending on your price point. But if you have solid surface floors, that's great as well. What I will tell you is today, home buyers like clean, more eco-friendly materials, and they don't feel carpet is very clean or eco-friendly. Any sort of hardwood or natural material is best, but even a laminate floor is great because it reduces allergens and is easier to clean. The next item on the list is a home entertainment center or theater room. And what I will tell you here is it's really important for each room in your house to have a defined purpose. Maybe it is a home theater room that you have, but if you're not lucky enough to have that, but you have a really great family area that you can maximize with the way it's laid out for multiple purpose. So it could be a TV room as well as a game room. Using staging or materials that you have to really emphasize the purpose of a room is really important. But as we know, TV, computers, screens, multimedia is such a part of our life today that home buyers really do like to see a place that can be a gathering space and have a large screen. Next on the list is a swimming pool. Now I would say that really depends on the age of the home buyers as well as where the property is located, but I do see several buyers honing out a swimming pool or at least a cabana club. So if you've got those features, great. Not worth your return on your investment to add that, of course. But if you do have them, make sure they're in great condition and they really help show off your property. And just below that is a hot tub. Now that is maybe something that's a little bit easier to add, but again, I wouldn't suggest adding that for a resale, but it is a great item to highlight or to point out if there's space for that, to sell and market that feature could be added. So that tops off the list. The bottom of the list you see there is actually other, and that is a catch-all. So there's a lot of important features when you're selling your house, but as I mentioned briefly before, having a defined space for each room is really important. And so I think that's gonna capture that other category there, is just make sure it's very clear to home buyers what they can do with that space and how they can use it. And that goes a lot into neutralizing and purging the space so they can envision their own life in there. So now let's quickly go through the best return on investment improvements. We kind of talked a little bit about that as we went through those features, but I do want to highlight a couple more areas. The first one is going to be fix anything that's broken or you know needs repair or is really old and needs updating. A lot of homeowners have this honey-do list or a to-do list, and it's important to take those items off that aren't necessarily improvements, but rather maintenance items. Make sure those are taken care of so that the home buyer knows you've really cared for your house. If you'd like more information on that, I have a great video for sellers on how to make your house present very well in a home inspection. It talks about key areas that home inspectors look for and that a lot of sellers don't do great on, so that you can be proactive on fixing those items before a home inspection. Take a look at the link above and below. Now, when you get your home inspection, sometimes there's items that come up in there, and there are a few categories that I would say are very intimidating. Fixing those items is gonna be a really great sign to the home buyer that you're doing your best to improve this property and take care of it. And there's items that can be really intimidating that definitely should be taken care of first. The first one is a roof. If you've got roof repairs, take care of them. Nobody wants to worry about a good roof over their head. The second one is foundation. Of course, that's huge. If you can fix the foundation, great. If it's not in your budget, at least get an actual report that defines what needs to be done to fix it and a dollar amount so that the home buyer can take that into account. The third is electrical. A lot of people are intimidated by electrical and don't feel safe around it and need to hire an electrician. So make sure you take care of that for them to take away that worry. And the last one is any aged or old furnace or air conditioning. If your furnace or air conditioning is at end of life, buyers don't want to worry about that item. You really need to update it and improve it before you put the house on the market. The next area is kind of related to the top features that home buyers are looking for, is a minor kitchen remodel is really going to help your return on your investment. I definitely recommend, as I mentioned, painting. Maybe sometimes it's a quick countertop change or backsplash change to really update the room and give it a new look. And then a master bath remodel. This again can be small. It could be replacing the vanity with something standard that you can find at a home improvement store, putting in a new mirror and new fixtures and making sure things are coordinating so that the room looks together and modern. The fourth area is to fix up your deck or backyard. Really spruce it up to make a comfortable space to gather. Maybe it means putting a fire pit out there, even if it's not built in, something to show the use of the space and what you could do. Also, colorful furniture or pillows that make it inviting are really minor things that can be done to really improve your outdoor space. And if you have a wooden deck, make sure it's in great shape. It maybe needs a fresh paint or a sanding job. Make sure it's well maintained so that and buyers can envision themselves moving right in. And I've mentioned this one a couple times. The fifth one is defined spaces. A lot of home buyers today are looking for a home office. Especially with COVID-19 and people working from home, that's really important. But here in San Jose area, there's a lot of high-tech workers who work different hours, and a home office has always been really critical in this area. So consider staging or preparing one of your areas as a home office. Even if it's not a bedroom and it's just a nook, make sure that you're showing where a home office space could be. And the last key item I would say that's gonna get you your return on your investment is upgrading all of your fixtures to the same finish in a modern finish. So some areas here in San Jose, because they were built in the 70s or even 60s, there's a lot of brass. Brass is out. Buyers don't want to see brass. So we need to remove brass fixtures, whether that's light fixtures or doorknobs or cabinet hardware. All of those items need to be updated. Today, oil rub bronze or a brushed nickel or even a chrome is acceptable. But it's really critical, if at all possible, that all areas of the home match. That gives your home a much more updated in sync feel, and it feels nicely remodeled and updated to the home buyer. And it helps it flow and photograph much better and market better when there's consistency from room to room. Now, that tops off my list of key areas to improve to get better return on your investment. If you'd like to get more information, I definitely have additional resources for you. I'm going to put some links below. The first one is to my curb appeal tips. You can download that sheet. Gives you several points to look at from the front of your house to really improve and increase the curb appeal of your property. Because if it's not attractive out front, people aren't going to want to come in and take a look, right? So make that front door and front entry and the whole front image of your property very attractive. The second thing I have to offer is prep tips to maximize your home's value. Now, we touched a little bit about those here in the video, but if you'd like a full extensive list, you can definitely download the PDF I have available as well. The link will be below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Teresa Wellman with homeownerexperience.com, your local San Jose, California realtor, and I look forward to answering any of your questions that you have. Feel free to comment below, or if you love this channel and topics about real estate in San Jose, please do subscribe. Talk to you next time.